let us see the second question of exercise 4.2. Again, we have to construct a quadrilateral GOLD where the length of the sides and the two diagonals are given. So again, it is like the same as the first construction which we have done. So let's construct, start with to draw or to construct a diagonal. So we should construct one diagonal which has a larger length. So you can see that the length OD, that is of 10 cm. So we should start with that. So let us construct. Diagonal, you can see here the length of this diagonal is 10 centimeters. So OD, as we have, it is of 10 centimeters. Now let us see that from point O, you have only one point, that is I. And from point D, you have L, which is of 5 centimeters. So first we have to obtain point L. So what we'll do, from point O, we should draw an arc of 7.5. And from D, we should draw an arc of 5 to obtain point L. So let us do that. An arc of 7.5 centimeter R from point O, the length of 7.5 centimeter arc, and from D, it is of 5 centimeter R. 5 centimeter arc from point D, 5 centimeter. We can see this both are intersecting and the intersecting point is L. Let us join this point L with point D and L with O. So only one vertex is left now. Let's see how we obtain it. So which one is left? That is G. So now look at this. We have this length LG, that is of 6, and GD, that is again of 6. So to obtain point G, one arc should be drawn from point D of 6 cm and one arc should be drawn from L of 6 cm. So let us do that. Let's take the length of the radius 6 cm here. Now, as we discussed, to obtain G, one arc should be drawn from L. You can see that L and G, they are the opposite side. L, so G must be somewhere in the opposite side. So let us draw an arc from point G. As you can see, this is of 6 cm. Another from point D, that is again of 6 cm. So you can see where they are intersecting. So they both are intersecting here. And let us give that point G. So we should join OG and OD. This is OG and OD. So this is the required quadrilateral. The name is GOLD. We can write this values. This is of 6 cm, again of 6, this is of 7.5, and this is of 5 cm. So now this is GOLD. This quadrilateral is of required measures. Thank you. Hello students, let's start with the new exercise. In the previous exercise, we learned that how to construct a quadrilateral where the four sides and a diagonal is given. In this questions are slightly different. As you observe that, again we have to construct a quadrilateral only. But in this quadrilateral, if you see that the name of the quadrilateral is LIFT, they have given LI, IF, TL, LF and IT. If I'll construct the rough diagram, you can see that LIFT, as we discussed earlier, the name of this vertex should be given in such a way that in a clock or anti-clockwise. So here I have given the name as, you can see it's anti-clockwise, LIFT. So when I just write the length of the sides which are given, so this is 4, 3, 2.5, and the length of the two diagonals are given. So this is how it is different than the previous questions which we have already done. This is how these questions are different. So now what we should do this? Now how this kind of question supposed to be done? Ye questions ab hum kaise karenge? When we have three sides and two diagonals. So let's learn here. Again as we discussed in the previous, hum sabse pehle kya karenge? That's true, a diagonal. But now you can see here in this question we have the two diagonals. Now which diagonal should I construct first? So you can go for any diagonal. Aap koi bhi ek diagonal, IT ya LF. You can construct any of this diagonal first. Aap koi bhi ek diagonals pehle construct kar sakte ho, koi bhi. Hum ek, one thing we should remember, ki we should construct that diagram first which has the larger length. It's not compulsory, but let's keep it like this throughout this exercise. हम ऐसा diagonal सबसे पहले construct करेंगे जिसका yes length बड़ा हो. So here we can see that LF that is of 4.5. So first of all, let us construct. We should construct a diagonal LF and the length is 4.5. So you can see here, this is LF, that is of 4.5. Now, which are the points are left to obtain? Now I and T. So let's see that which is common vertex from L and F we have, we can obtain. So L se hume do sides hai, ek LT hai aur ek LI hai. Magar F se humare paas sirf ek side hai, that is LI. So we can say that I is common vertex which can obtain from L and F. So remember we should construct two arcs, one from L of 4 cm and one from F that is of 3 cm. When I'll do this, the intersecting point that is the vertex I. So let's do that. The length of 4 cm we should construct. This should be done from point L. This is point L, this is a 4 cm arc and from F a 3 cm radius. This is 3 cm. Let us construct from point F. We can see here this both are intersecting and that is I. Let us join this LI, it is 4.5. No, as the length is given 4 and this is another that is of 3. So as we obtain this one and this one. Now which one is left? From L it's T and from I it is T. So ab do arcs lagenge, one of 2.5 cm from point L, L se ek arc lagega 2.5 ka. और आई से एक आर्क लगेगा 4 सेंटीमीटर का. नाउ वी कैन सी दैट आई एंड टी दे आर इन द ऑपोजिट ऑफ एल एफ. सो एज आई इज ऑन द अपर साइड सो टी मस्ट बी ऑन द लोअर साइड. सो रिमेंबर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस वी शुड कंस्ट्रक्ट एन आर्क फ्रॉम पॉइंट एल. लेट अस कंस्ट्रक्ट एन आर्क ऑफ 2.5 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम पॉइंट एल. एल से एक आर्क लगेगा 2.5 सेंटीमीटर का and one arc from point I and that is of 4 cm. That is of 4 cm. Yes. So this is the length of 4 cm from point I. We should construct it. So we can see that this both are intersecting. This intersecting point is T. Let us join this point L with T. And this is F with T and IT. So this is the required quadrilateral LIFT is obtained. Let us note it down all this length. This is 4. This is 4. This is 2.5. And FI that is of 3. So this is the required quadrilateral ABCD required quadrilateral LIFT is obtained. Thank you. Let us continue with the question number 3. That is the third number of question 1, that is of exercise 4.2. This question is one of the most important question of both the exercise 4.1 and 4.2. It's a very important question. Why it is an important? Let us see. So here in this, the quadrilateral which we have to construct, it's a special type and it's a rhombus which we have to construct. Rhombus B, E and D which we have to construct. And you can see that which dimensions they have given here. They have given BN and DE. That is BN and DE. So the length of the diagonals are given. No sides are given here. So that is why this is very important. If you want to do this correctly, again as we discussed earlier, we should have the clear concept of properties of rhombus. So when we recall the properties of the rhombus, we remember that diagonals of rhombus, they bisect each other at right angle. This is very important property which you have to understand. What it means, the diagonals BN and DE, they bisect. Bisect, that means divide into two equal parts. So we can say BO and ON are of same length. That is half of 5.6, that is 2.8 and 2.8. Similarly, O is the midpoint of DE, so we can say OE and OD are of same length. So this is the reason this question is very important. As we understand the property, now the question arises that how we will construct this rhombus. So as we discussed earlier, when the two diagonals are there, only diagonals are there, so we should draw one of the diagonals. Let's see that how we'll do this. So let us draw one of the diagonal. Now which diagonal should I draw? So let us draw the length which is larger, that is DE. So the length of DE, that is 6.5. So we should construct here 6.5 centimeter line segment. That is 6.5 or ED, whatever you want to give the name. Now the most important, now how to obtain the rest of the two vertex B and N. Now this property says that the diagonals bisect each other at a right angle. Matlab, if I want to construct the another diagonal here, that is BN. So remember, BN must passes from the midpoint and it is a perpendicular bisector. Now let us understand what is perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular matlab which form a right angle. Bisector, that means passing from the midpoint. So we have to construct such a line segment which passing from the midpoint of DE and is perpendicular to this line segment. So we have already discussed how to do this in the 7th standard. So let us recall this again. What I am going to do the next step, I am going to construct the perpendicular bisector of this given line segment, which is of 6.5 centimeter. So to obtain the midpoint or to construct the perpendicular bisector, what we should do? Let's take the length of the radius, which is more than half of the line segment, approximately more than half. From point E, we should draw an arc which is on the above side. Keep the same radius and draw another arc on the lower side. Now without changing the length of the radius, from point D, we should draw another arc which intersect the previous two arc at two distinct points. As we can see here, this both the points are intersecting. Let us join them. So this line segment which I am constructing right now, this is called perpendicular bisector. As it is a bisector and this point is considered as the midpoint of DE, let us give that point O. So from the diagram you can see this is point which we obtain O. Now as we have the length of BN 5.6 centimeter. So as we discussed earlier, BO is half of 5.6. So half of this, that is 2.8. So what we will do, now we should take the length of 2.8 centimeter. 2.8 centimeter. From point O, we should draw one arc on the OS above on this side and one arc on this side. So this both are intersecting point. Let us give this point B for Bombay and now join this all the points, that is BD, that is DN, EN and BE. So here you can see that this B, E and D is a rhombus. Let's measure all this length of the sides. They must be equal. If you want to measure like this with the help of rounder, it is quite easy. Let's take this length. You can see it must be the same. It must be the same. As we can see that all the lengths are of equal measures. So as it is a rhombus and the diagonals we can see here, they bisect each other at right angle. This is 2.8, this is 2.8. So the whole length is 5.6 centimeter. So students, remember, this is the most important question of this exercise.